So get free about that.
Amen.
Praise the Lord, when you preach now and read fast in the scripture, why can I preach? Praise the Lord. Mm-hmm. You see, when you go contrary to what some of you prefer, then you, your ideas. They preach 2 hours a day and, you know, word.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord God. Preach your textbook, but on a matter of time, it costs you something that's near and dear that has you bound. Amen. Praise the Lord God.
Thank you,
God. By the grace of the living God. In season, praise the Lord God. Out of season. Three seasons. Praise the Lord God. Praise the Lord God. All night. Amen. Amen.
Praise God.
You have to do it. You have to be ready now, children, because we need to hold nothing in Revelation.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
Now, dear Lord, the God of my hope live, there are some answers that only come through perseverance. But we want to test you. When you hear God's children, you may well set yourself. That's why the apostle said, exercise yourself unto godliness. You've got to be conditioned.
That's right.
You've got to be conditioned. If you're not in condition, dear one, there are some things you cannot even bring yourself to do. There's no way in the world I could run in a marathon race. I couldn't run 2 miles at top speed or at any speed without a few rest periods. Why? I've got to be conditioned. Because the one behind me, I can make it. Amen, amen. And dear ones, there are some people who are so heavy in their spirits, they just cannot bring them, they don't have a very ball to pray for. Now, I want to tell you something tonight. Don't think that you can be immediately thrust into some serious situation and then all of a sudden get a spirit of prayer. And get a persevering spirit. I'm going to tell you. Praise the Lord God, you better try to preach from all night now while things are fairly good. Oh, you think, well, if I get out of it, I get pushed in the corner, I'll just turn on the prayer.
No,
I'll put the prayer for you. No, you better exercise yourself now. You cannot bring yourself to do what's not in you. You cannot do that because you are incapable of doing it. Some of you just can't do it because they don't have a result. They just can't pray. They can't go so far. Their spiritual endurance will only take them so far. That's why they want to know people don't have time for a lot of frolics and banqueting and all that foolishness.
Amen.
Why? Because they don't have the time. They don't have the word of God. They don't have the ability to pray through as it is. Amen. They're already asleep, but they don't even know the sedative. Amen. Mark chapter 2. Beginning at verse 1. And again he entered into Capernaum after some days, and it was known that he was in the house. And straightway many were gathered together, insomuch that there was no room to receive them. No, not so much as an upper door. And he preached the word unto them. And they came to him bringing one sick apostle, which was born afore. And when they could not come nigh after him from the press, praise the Lord, they had come to the roof. Great water. And when they had broken it up, he let out the bed, wearing the sick upon the lady. When Jesus saw that faith, he said unto the sick upon the son, thy sin be forgiven thee. When he saw that faith, when he saw that perseverance, the one you remember your objective is to get to Jesus. Now, whatever is necessary, whatever obstacles you might encounter en route, but the question is to get to Jesus. Amen. Now, even in your prayer meeting, you don't just come to say some words to two or three people, four or three people that go home. You come to get to Jesus.
Yeah.
Now, if you don't get to Jesus, you're going to be home. That's why I said you can wait some time in the word and some else otherwise.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. They're taking one to get to Jesus.
Amen.
Now, what is necessary to get to Jesus? If you've got to pray 2 hours, 3 hours, 4 hours, 1 hour, kind of seemingly impossible situation surrounding them. People crowded in at the door, and the press was so great they couldn't break their way through. And God said, we're going to give it to Jesus.
Amen.
I mean, you're going to tap the house. If you want to be saved, bring down God. Our Lord, our baby, you're going to take it for destruction of property. They don't care if you give it to Jesus.
Amen.
Hey, if you got any questions here, I don't care. Bring down, we give it to Jesus. Give it here. Because we can't get in the door. Can't come under with that roof on. Amen.
Amen.
God, under that.
Amen.
But what happened out of that,
yes.
I said there were some things you're only going to get through perseverance. Matthew, if you have to persevere, I don't care how holy you are, you just won't have it. Some people think, well, I'm in the Lord, see my pitiful condition, and he's just going to come on down and see if I can down this perseverance. Yeah. The Holy Ghost never thinks you can work together because you are in a pitiful situation. And you've got to let the Lord know that you must have some grace.
Yes.
And he demands it in some instances because you wouldn't appreciate it anyway if you got to meet him. And the Lord knows that.
True.
He knows that. So he's going to make sure that you want it. So that when you get it, you'll appreciate it. So sometimes when you're going to have to circumvent, go around and through and over and everything else. But get to Jesus.
Amen.
And whatever you can get that, get down.
Amen.
Gotcha. Amen. Too many people have a season or two of prayer. Oh, God will for me to die. God will for me not to have it. God will for this. God will for that. God will for the other.
Yes.
But indeed, it's not God's will. Yes. It's your lack of perseverance. They all came to God with you. Told you that it was impossible. And you succumbed to that idea. And you didn't get it. And in some instances, you want to charge God because you were in such a desperate situation and he wouldn't alleviate you. Well, God, you stopped short. You were not in a spiritual condition. You spent your time laying on a spiritual beach somewhere. Amen. Lying around when you should have been on your feet, getting in condition to pray through, to break through some of these barriers. Sometimes people suffer things 10 times as long as they would normally have to. Why? Because they won't get the full God to pray through. They think God is just going to arbitrarily do it. But no. Some things God has left you, and the result is dependent on you.
Amen.
And you alone. You're going to pray through, it will happen. You can tell that. Oh, what needless pain we bear.
Yeah.
Oh, what needless circumstances we suffer. Not because we have to, not because God has to say about your situation, but because he's left enough you to pray it through. Pray it through, not puff it through. Not scheme it through. Not plot it through. Pray it through.
Good.
Amen. You'd be surprised for a night of real prayer for you, prayer fasting. You'd be really surprised or amazed as a result of the praying, real prayer, and less discussing and less plotting and less all about it. Amen, amen, amen.
Amen.
So you can move God. God made himself available to be moved.
Yes.
Amen. But you have to be moved first in the right way.
Right.
Amen.
Not with indignation, but concern for the kingdom of God. Amen. See, God cannot be moved with your indignation or your animosity. He's got to be moved when you are moved by a right motive, purpose.
Amen.
Amen. Said there are some things we'll only get through perseverance. Mark chapter 10, verse 46. And they came to Jericho, and as he went out of Jericho with his disciples, a great number of people, blind Bartimaeus, the son of Timaeus, sat by the highway side begging. And when he heard that it was Jesus of Nazareth, he began to cry out and say, Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy on me. Men charged him that he should hold his peace, but he cried the more a great deal. We love God when you really want something, you're not so easy to shut up.
Amen.
Amen. When people heal pretty already, why don't you go with that? read, pray out of God, don't have it in your life, and then be in the Levi. Amen. Try again. And may the charm diminish it. Holy Spirit. Shut up, man. I don't have time for you. But he cried the more a great deal. He's praying out of God. I need a blessing.
Amen.
I mean, I need a rain, pray God for a blessing.
Yes, sir.
Get it over here. Amen. That's why those people who remain in Babylon of knowing that irrespective to your plight, God will reach you. The Bible says, the great love of God, He'll give us beauty.
But God showed me that I should not call for a man coming unto me.
mine unto you without gainsaying. As soon as I was sent, I mean, God sent me. I asked therefore, for what intent have you sent for? What you want with me? I'm not supposed to be down here, but praise God, and hear what you want. Hallelujah. I mean, God sent somebody who didn't intend to come and take care of me. Amen. God, I think God did that. It's sure that I'm living. Say the God I told, say the God in this instance. I was in service. And I didn't say too long, but I would faithfully fast before the Lord. Every week I would fast from Sunday to Tuesday. And that Sunday I hadn't eaten in a while, and I didn't want to go on a fast hungry. And I came from church late that night, and I kept the bus and ride a long way to the barracks. And I was so hungry. I was desperate. I was all up here for clothes and everything else. And I thought, I'm so hungry. And the battery of the dog and everything was still, this is true that I was told. And Lord, he told me to walk around the barracks. I walked around the barracks, and a fella was laying up there, he was drinking some other big shiny package on his chest. I said, what you got there? He said, I got a sandwich. I said, thank you, I got a sandwich. I said, what you said? You can have it.
Hallelujah. And I'm going to give the a graphic description.
thou hast well done with our company. Now therefore, are we all here present before God to hear all the things that are commanded of God? We'll leave. Just don't preach this. Amen. Just don't come across this in anything else. Don't give up on your eyes. Don't give up the faith of God. When you open up to God, you're not arguing. When you open up to God, you're not cussing. When you open up to God, pray to God, you're not trying to preach it on. They don't even be praying. What did he say? Praise God. We've been in it. And we've been in church 4 days, praying and fasting. Hallelujah. What did he got to say? Thank God. Tell him, say, oh, I don't care. Praise God. How close it. Cut me. How low it bring me. I'm ready to hear it. People who want to hear from God have a certain attitude. Amen. People who want to be something for God, they have a certain attitude. Thank God. People don't come out of God and try to tell you that same thing, Lord. They don't get saved telling you what, amen, y'all want too far. Praise God. There are certain attitudes that are coming with a person who gets real Bible salvation.
Amen.
There are certain resignation and humility that goes along with it.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I don't care what it is. What it is, it's just pour out. Praise God, we're ready to receive. Amen. I know it. Verse 1 and 4. While Peter yet spake these words, hallelujah, the Holy Ghost was on all of them, which heard the word. Thank God, Peter was preaching about the Holy Ghost. Amen. You see what he was preaching in the former verses. You probably know that about himself because the experience was new with him. But God knew what he needed. God knew the Lord in his heart. Praise God. He knew that part. He knew what he was going on a second time. Thank God. He better know all the details. Let's get out of the face with God. He'll show you.
Yeah.
Amen. Hey, just persevere with God. Just insist that I will turn God loose. Amen. Until he meets you. Believe.
Amen.
Amen. Just one or two more scriptures. Over James chapter 5. Praise God for you. Thank the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Praise God.
Amen. Behold, we count them happy which endure, which endure, which hold on, which hold on the faith of God. Ye have heard of the faith of Jehovah. He said, thank God, God gave you these things as an example. The Lord wrote these things for your encouragement. You've heard the faith of Jehovah and have seen, thank God, the end of the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Isn't that encouraging? The end of the Lord. Even though God broke Job below, you saw his final end. Even though God stripped it, thank God that that end was better than the first. God doesn't bring a man to the Lord just for the sake of the praise of God.
Amen.
And through his, he's trying to accomplish a purpose through your life. And when he's accomplished that purpose, praise of God. He's going to make you better than you were at the first. Praise of God. Amen. Thank the Lord. And the Lord is very pitiful. And I've tended mercy. Hallelujah. Endure, children. Praise our God. One other scripture. A prayer to you. Quiet at the company. Over Luke chapter 22. Verse 4.
Themselves because just praying gives you a certain consolation.
Many times God convicts people and they come to the altar and pray. But they pray just enough to get relief, not get the answer. And the enemy tricks them and they go away from the altar with the same problem existing that they came with. But Jesus knew his own spirit. And he knew when he had victory, and he knew when he did not. He knew when he prayed through, he knew when he had not. So the Bible says he went back and prayed more earnestly. Jesus had decided he would shed his blood and had his body.
Yes.
If it became necessary, he would submit to the will of God. The Bible says he went back and prayed more earnestly.
Mm-hmm.
Until his spirit was gone and the angels had administered to it. That's why people don't get into the lady. They are unwilling to put them here. They pray a little superficial prayer. And if they don't, God doesn't act out of their heart, well, maybe it's not God's will. I pray if anything happens, so I'm going to go and do the next best thing.
Coming up.
That will get you to yourself, you want. Amen. Jesus had to put it here. You're going to have to do it.
Yes.
You're going to have to be in spiritual condition, dear ones. It will condition yourself now because Jesus said in your patience, the best ye, your soul.
Yes.
That's going to determine, that's going to be your ticket when Jesus comes. Your ability to hold out and stand on what God says alone. If the Lord says this is your lot for life, you have to have the work all down in your own soul to submit to it. Irrespective, it might be one fault of rain, it might be contrary to your wishes.
Yes.
It might be the thing that, knowing that you're really vital, but your ability to hold out, your ability to win on God,
yes,
your ability to persevere and pray through, don't be a ticket when Jesus comes again. And you need to know when you have and when you don't. You need to know when you have the word of God down in your soul and pray through when you don't. I'm going to tell you something, children. Some circumstances are going to face you in these last evil days. If you don't have a hold it, you'll get going to run out of it. That's what happens to the Williams. If you're uncareful, you're going to get caught in a traffic jam. You're going to recognize that the circumstances that are coming upon you is going to require more than you have at your disposal. And you're going to realize that you don't have it, and you're going to try to move to the all stop, but you're going to find some closed space underneath your kibble. So all stop over now. You can get all of your vessels if you so desire. You can get that which is necessary to take you through these things that are coming up on you. But there are people right now, they're tired and they're sluggish. And even though God might show them the need, they right now don't have the word of God to pray through. They're not going to have a prayer Bible, but I'll work on it. But if you want to say something, you're going to have to come to grips with your situation. And I'm going to hold over to God and bring the answer. We allow things to persist too long. When there's something there, that's not that you go to God, that means things have a part there. You're probably going to find something in it. And then when you find something, as sure as you live, he's going to explore it. He's going to explore it. He's going to glow it to get out of the horse. You can't have it at all.
Amen.
You want, don't leave this meeting. It's good rejoice. You could testify a good thing, but don't leave this meeting without perfect faith.
Amen.
Whatever you get, tell them. We don't wait for a song. Don't wait for this meeting. Don't wait for any coercion. You know you're right. Don't deceive yourself. To know yourself, you want a premium. To know your own ability is a premium. Don't get in the midst of a situation and find out that you don't have it.